Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. This is Aaron, and today we're taking a look at the iPulse Boston Series Minimalist Wallet. Now you may be thinking, Aaron, come on, wallets, really? Why? Hear me out. So our EDC, or our everyday carry, are the things that we carry with us on a day-to-day basis, in our bags, our wallets, whatever, the stuff that we use. And each person's EDC is just as unique from person to person as the tech that we're using. So to me, EDC falls under that tech category, and wallets just happen to, conveniently enough, fall under EDC. Packaging for the wallet's pretty straightforward. It just comes in a cardboard sleeve, and inside of that sleeve, obviously you would get the wallet, and then it also has a moisture absorbent pad or a slip, almost like a piece of tissue paper almost, that I'm 98.6% sure I threw away. So that's in the trash somewhere in some landfill. But other than that, it's not a bad experience. I was kind of hoping for a little bit more, but we're talking a wallet here, so it doesn't need to have like LED lights and like super fancy packaging to get the point across. As expected, the wallet is very small and works out great in tighter fitting pants like skinny jeans, or it works out great in a front pocket, which is how I use it. Or if you want to put it into a back pocket and you just don't want to get the butt cramps, you know, that you get from having like a thick bifold wallet that has like every club membership card you've ever had and has like, you know, 14 debit cards and 22 credit cards, because that's a smart thing to do. this does a good job of trimming you down to the basics and fits in almost every kind of usage case that you are going to want to have for it. Real quick before going any further, I want to give a quick shout out to iPulse for sending out this wallet for me to share with you guys. The wallet can hold 10 cards on the middle pouch, which is the pouch that's meant to hold most of your cards. I have 8 in mine, and I don't have a single problem with it. After a couple of weeks of carrying it, it stretched out a little bit and it holds those 8 no problem. Before that, it still held them. It was a tighter fit, but that's expected with wallet, or with wallet with leather, you have to kind of wear it in a little bit. So to get to that middle pouch, there is a buttoned clasp that goes around the top. You pop that button, and then that button is attached to a piece of fabric. To get to your cards, since they're inside the wallet, you just lift straight up on that piece of fabric. And when you lift up on that fabric, your cards kind of come up. That lets you choose what cards that you want or what card that you want. And when you let go of that piece of fabric, it actually automatically recedes back to the bottom. And all you have to do is just kind of gently push your cards back down, put the clasp back over, and you're ready to rock. I was concerned with that button clasp when I first started using the wallet. I was afraid it was going to get in, you know, get in between me being able to get my wallet out of my pants, because I do wear skinny fitting jeans at times, or just tighter jeans in general. And when you wear those pants, of course, your wallets and your pockets are a lot tighter. I've had no issues. Kind of pro tip though, is to face that clasp towards you so that when you're pulling the wallet out of your pocket, that lip of the clasp isn't gonna catch on the thick lip of your pants and it won't come undone that way. So, little pro tip. On one side of the wallet, there's another pouch that holds one more card, and this card has a little notch cut out of the bottom of it. I put my main use debit card here because I can just kind of push my finger through that little slot and push my card out, that I can get to my main use card pretty quickly. If you flip the wallet around, this is where the cash goes. So this wallet is minimal, holds few cards, but then can also hold a little bit of cash. Their Amazon posting page or listing page mentions that it can hold 15 bills. I think that's pushing it a little bit. I mean, if you want to use a little pouch at the bottom, there's an elastic band and then there's a pouch at the bottom to kind of just to hold the cash. I did put some bills in there, you know, kind of stretch that out a little bit, and it will hold more than what it would when I first got it. But I still think 15 is pushing it if you're wanting to use that pouch at the bottom. If you're just wanting to use the elastic band, you can probably swing 15 bills, no problem. But just from my experience, I probably wouldn't try cramming that many into that little pouch at the bottom. When you take the wallet out of the packaging, you will also realize that there is a lanyard that's attached to the wallet. This is meant, you know, to kind of hold a key, or to hold your keys, or have your keys on that chain so then you can connect it to your wallet. I don't use it. I instantly took it off of there, but if that's something that you want to do, it's on the wallet and it works. It's just not something that really, you know, floats my fancy or anything like that. Even with that lanyard not on the wallet, that little ring's not a big deal. You know, it does move, so it's not like it just sticks straight out and it's a pain. It's just something that's there. So one of the big things that I'm a fan of here is that there's actually no branding on the outside of this wallet. I totally understand why companies brand everything. I mean, I get it. It makes perfect sense. But to have a wallet that doesn't have any kind of branding on the outside of it with the black one that I've got, it looks super clean and just looks really nice. If for some reason you don't like black and maybe you want brown instead, they do have a cognac brown as well. And it also doesn't have any kind of branding on it. The wallet also has RFID blocking built into it, so you have that peace of mind, though I think in today's day and age, you probably are more likely to lose your identity from using the public Wi-Fi network at Starbucks, or clicking on that stupid email that says that you won $1 million from some king in Africa. I think you're more likely to lose your information that way, but it doesn't hurt to have that extra little feature in there either. If you're looking for a slim wallet that will hold the necessities and doesn't have any, you know, extra fluff that you don't really need, it's just good at what it does, I definitely suggest the iPulse Boston Series Minimalist Wallet. If this video was helpful to you at all, please hit that like button. If you want to see more consumer tech and EDC reviews on tech that I use and enjoy, and think you will too, hit that subscribe button. But until the next one, this is Aaron. Take care.